Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Reversible Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create a complex wall and ceiling design in Revit. By create those complex wall and ceiling, we need to using our adaptive component to create that. And of course on my screen here, we got some photo reference. It's a different option about ceiling design before we jumping into our project. Okay, so I will pick one of them to create into our Revit architecture template. So before I get started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out to my channel and you want to learn more about Revit, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for all notifications so you won't miss my future tutorial. I think it's pretty much. Let's speak into our project together. Okay, so now I am in Revit architecture template. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to explain you a quick instruction. First thing you need to create some family about adaptive component for profile, and secondly we will create another adaptive component also, but it's a form. The reason we create two different family because our first family is about profile and second family is about form. One I change later on is I want to change my shape or change my dimension. I just straight away go to my profile, then update only on my profile. After update my adaptive profile, I'm going to load to another adaptive component form, so they will update it automatically or directly. This is the reason and how the exact way to control your adaptive family. Okay, so now I think it's pretty much for explanation. Let's speak into our real family together. So I'm going to file here, then go to new, go to our family as away English, then finding for metric model, generic model adaptive is open up. When I open that, I'm going to my reference there, straight away just for point element, make sure you draw on work plan and draw for the center here, hit escape, select my point here, and of course I will make it an adaptive, and I'm going to set a plan, set for vertical, start from front here, I'm going to start from front, rectangle, make sure you turn off for 3D snapping. Then I'm going to start work on plan first. Actually, I need to set a plan first again. Okay, perfect. It's time to draw that. I'm going to draw it something like this. Hit escape a couple of times first. And AL for align. Align from my point here until my line there. The reason is we need to lock that. Hit escape. DI for dimension shortcut key. Start a dimension here, make it equal. Okay, perfect. Add another family here for dimension. Sorry, not family, it's a dimension. And then I'm going to add another one as well. Hit escape. I'm going to change scale for 1x2 because later on I will make our profile smaller. This is the reason. So I'm going to assign for a new parameter property. Make it about width. It's okay. And this guy over there, we will make it for height for shortcut key, character height. Go to our family, then of course when you assign for a new parameter, you will saw another tool here. The height here is the previous, and W is our previous parameter that we create. I'm going to give it about 500 mm half meter, and this guy over there make it about 35 cm. Apply, it's okay. As you can see, it's quite perfect because we got trained it already. This is the reason. Let me see first. Is it perfect? Okay, there we need to make it 35.0. Apply. Perfect. Now I'm going to create another adaptive component. Go to our file, then go to new family. We just repeat our previous process. When I read on another adaptive component, I'm going to reference and point element, simply point here, hit escape, select my point there, make it an adaptive, then I'm going to copy that, CO for copy, make sure you turn on for constraint and multiple selection. So I'm going to copy that about 11. Later on, I will explain for you more why I need to create until 11. Hit escape first. Go to our 3D before for our previous profile. Load in, load to family sec. It's okay. Okay, as you can see, then I can start plus here. Okay, the reason for that because we press from front, so here we got some problem already, as you can see there. So I'm going to hit escape first. Let me check first, is it we can flip it? Okay, here we just flip like this only. So let me try first, is it we can rotate it? If we cannot rotate it, we will start to press our adaptive again. Let me start like this first. Okay, so we cannot. So I'm going to select my previous here. Then just delete it. Again, select my adaptive. Start from top here. Then CO for copy. Start copy from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Hit escape first. Okay, perfect. We got our profile, we got our adaptive point. So what we need to do, we need to create form. Simply select all of our profile here. As you can see here, is our profile. This is the reason I create profile. So later on, if you want to change shape, you just go to your profile here and then you can change directly that upload into that. So I'm going to create form, solid form, as you can see here. So I will testing out my adaptive. Let's say I want to switch here like this. Zoom in a bit. As you can see, this is the reason we are using for adaptive. So I can select Ctrl Z first, then I can select all my form there. Of course, I need for assign a new parameter for material as well. So after that, now we open another family for material, create new material, simply rename it for wood. Then go to our apparent library there. Wood, then I'm going to use raw but natural supply. It's okay. Once I done that, I'm going to load into my project first. Load two projects. One is our project. Okay, first step we done, second step we done. Let's create our cap, our curve. RP for shortcut key, I'm going to pop up from here until here, make it for one, hit escape. Then I'm going to cop AR for array. I'm going to array it about 3 meter and make it about 5. Hit escape a couple times. Go to our sound elevation. Then I'm going to our mask, in place mask 1. And using our spline here. This is the reason we create our reference plane. Start from reference here 1. Okay. Then I can start from here. Make it something like this. Basically here you can free draw. And we adjustment make it more snidely. Okay, I like my first one. I think something like this is perfect. Then I can go to my level 1 here. Go to our sound elevation again. Go to level 1. Then I need to copy that. Copy until reference 3. Need to untick for constraint first. Okay. Then I need to go to our sound elevation again. Actually, I need to copy here as well. Go to our level 1 again. Then copy that. Okay, hit escape. Go to our sound elevation. Then I'm going to edit the profile a bit more, make it more like this. Yep, then I'm going to select my four profile here. Go to our, let's go to our 3D view first. Okay, then I'm going to select here again. Go to our level one. Then CO for copy, start from here and unconstrained until here. You can create any curve that you want, but here just a quick example, I will make it something like this. You can see here we just edit the last one like this, then select 1 2 3 4, create form, solid form. You can see we got another form. Then simply select my form there, device surface, make our surface here about 20 and hit apply. Okay, perfect. Go to our small arrow here, then open node here. It's okay. Okay, once you done that, as you can see in our property here, we got only 410 for vGrill, but I count it by 11 on my adaptive component. If you count that, you will saw 11. Okay, so now let's play that. CM for shortcut key component, then you can start platform here. 1 2, I will continue here. As you can see, it's 11. Then I can hit escape first. As you can see here, once I done that, I just select my adaptive component here. Then repeat our process here. So the read will be processing and file will be regenerating just a few seconds. As you can see here, it's quite fast and quite nice. And of course, you can create any curve and any ceiling design. I just give you a quick concept to create that. One, when I done that, I can turn on for realistic. Will be changed to realistic. It's a wood material there. As you can see, it's quite nice. You can apply your wall as well on that. As you can see here. Okay, so you can apply any material as well. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you for joining me from start to finish. I hope this tutorial can help you out. Thank you for watching and I see you for another tutorial in reviews, and have a nice day. Thank you.